Hi everyone, and thank you for stopping by. This is going to be a kind of different vlog than the usual vlogs we do. It's kind of going to be a Mother's Day special, a kind of explanation, and kind of explain to you why we decided to start vlogging and why we created this YouTube channel. Sunday just gone was also Mother's Day, so this will show what I got up to this Mother's Day and also explain a few other things. If you are regulars to our channel and you watch our vlogs recently, then you may have seen that last Wednesday when Chris vlogged taking Isla swimming on that snowy day, he said during that vlog that I was at an appointment with my sister at the hospital, and I'm going to show you what that appointment was about. So here's what I got up to on Wednesday just gone, the 2nd of March. Today is Wednesday. Oh my gosh, I've got snow on my eyelash. Today is Wednesday, the 2nd of March, and as you can see, it's snowing. I'm here today with my beautiful sister. And we've got a really, really exciting day ahead of us. And I've also got with me, Boo. Say hi, Harvey. He's too shy. My little nephew Harvey. We've got a really, really exciting day planned, and I will tell you more about that in a bit. But now I'm running inside to take cover because I'm getting snowed on really bad. We're just coming to McDonald's to get some breakfast. See you soon. What have you got, Harvey?
Dad.
The porridge. We just dropped Harvey off at his grandma and granddad's, and now me and Katrina are on our way to a really special appointment. And that appointment is... That's not a chubby belly. That is my little nephew growing nicely. Well, we're going to have a scan today to... No, to make sure he's growing nicely. I will explain that comment Katrina just said. She said, if you didn't hear, I thought you were going to say his name. And I will explain why she said that, because I am the only person, including Katrina and the baby's daddy, that knows the baby's name.
Included?
Yeah, I'm the only one that knows the name of the baby. So we're just on our way for a scan, yay! Katrina's 30 weeks pregnant and she's having a scan today because Harvey was born early at 35 weeks her waters went, so she's having a scan today just to make sure everything's okay.
If we get there on time.
If we get there on time, we've got 2 minutes. just had the scan and they wouldn't let me film. I did get a little bit before she made me stop. I was just going to show you the pictures, but we've just had to give the pictures. She put the pictures in her notes, and her notes have just had to go to reception because we're now waiting for a clinic appointment, where hopefully they'll be able to tell us the weight. Katrina's got the giggles.
Who was that making me laugh?
So we just got back to the car to drive back home after being at the hospital, and little Squishy is growing really well. Everything's fine, he's healthy, everything looks really good. He weighs currently, what?
3.4 pounds.
Cute! And we've got 10 more weeks until his due date, so yep, 9 plus 4, Katrina just corrected me, don't be adding on days. 9 weeks and 4 days. So it's now, what time is it, Katrina? Just gone 2. We're just gonna head to a couple of shops before going and picking up my niece and nephew from school, and that's the plan. My sister's pregnant with my little nephew, and I am so excited for him to arrive and really can't wait for a new baby to huggle and snuggle and kind of something really nice and happy and exciting to happen in our family, because 2015 was a crazy roller coaster of a year for me. I had amazing ups, and that was my wedding. And then I had quite devastating lows, and that's what I'm going to explain in this vlog. And I'm going to explain why this Mother's Day was very different from any other Mother's Day we've had before. We would usually have a really fun family day, kind of like our Valentine's Day vlog. We enjoy spending time together as a family and get up to loads of fun things. However, this Mother's Day was unfortunately my first Mother's Day without a mum. Kind of hard to say that out loud. In November of 2015, last year, I lost my mum to cancer. She wasn't old, she was 48. And we only found out that she had cancer in May. I think it was the 20th of May, somewhere near the start of May, we kind of found out that there was something there. We weren't sure what. We kind of had a feeling it might be cancer. And then on the 20th of May is the day that we found out it was terminal. It was stage 4 and small cell cancer, which is one of the worst and most aggressive cancers. And it was basically not a good prognosis. My mum also had COPD, which is a lung disease, and she had heart failure, basically fluid around her heart. And they basically told us that chemotherapy would be extremely risky for her to have. And To give chemotherapy, she'd need a biopsy, and to do the biopsy, they would need to take a sample of the cancer from her lung. But because she had COPD and her lungs were already so damaged, the biopsy would hold huge risks, and if her lung collapsed, the other lung wouldn't be strong enough to keep her going. And basically, it was just devastating. It was the worst news we could have expected. To make it even harder, I mean, no time would ever be good to be told your mum's got an incurable disease, but to make it even harder, we found this out in May. I asked the doctor if he could give us an approximate time. We were looking at months, years, you know, we just didn't know. And he told me that she was looking at 3 to 4 months left. This is always going to be hard to hear. However, my wedding was booked for October 10th, and from May, that's 5 months away. And to be told your mum's got 3 to 4 months to live, and your wedding's 5 months away, a wedding that you've both been planning for 2 years. She helped choose my dress, and you know, the thought of her maybe not being able to see me in the wedding dress, it was just a feeling that I'll never be able to explain. It was soul destroying and just terrible. However, my mum was such an amazing person. She was so brave, so strong. She just smiled the whole way through. And she basically said she didn't care what the risks were. She didn't care if only 5% chance that they'd get a good result from the biopsy that would mean that she could take the chemotherapy. She didn't care. She was trying for that biopsy. She was trying the chemotherapy. And she was doing everything she could to get to my wedding. And that's what she did. She had the biopsy and she started chemotherapy. She was really ill. She lost her hair. But she smiled the whole way through. She never got down. She was the strong one. She was the one that kept us all going. And I just can never explain the strength that I took from her when really it should have been the other way around. She was just incredible. So initially she was offered 4 rounds of chemotherapy. And then the plan after that was we'd kind of see how it worked, how her body coped with it. And then we'd go from there. The first 2 rounds shrunk the tumour quite a lot. And we celebrated, we were really excited. We thought maybe a miracle was going to happen. And it was a little bit of positive news and gave us the boost that we all really desperately needed. However, after meeting with the doctor after the 3rd and 4th round, we found that the cancer was too strong and the chemotherapy was no longer working. The cancer was growing again. We had a few setbacks where it was growing so much that it was compressing her heart and causing fluid to build up around her heart, which caused her a huge amount of pain. She was admitted to hospital. This was all approximately a month before my wedding, and it was just a really difficult time. However, she managed to get to my wedding day, and that's just something that I'll always be grateful for. I can't imagine having wedding pictures without my mum in them, and the fact that I've got those memories now, have the pictures to remember, and I'll know that she got to the day that she was fighting to get to, and she got there. So she was happy with that. We both had the most amazing day. My sister pushed her down the aisle just before I came in as she was in a wheelchair. And the vicar did a really special kind of mum dedication, which I'd made for her in the church. So she got to stand up and come to the front and light a candle with me and Chris. And it was just perfect. It was the best day. And it was so much more special because my mum was there, and it made us appreciate it even more. Here are a few pictures from my wedding day with my mum. So now that that was over and my mum had got to the wedding day, I now had another dilemma, as I was due the next day to fly to America for 3 weeks for my honeymoon. Obviously, I was so excited for this huge adventure that awaited us. We'd been saving for so long and planning this trip for 2 years, and we were so excited. Everything was booked and paid for. The girls were beyond excited. They were going to see the princesses and Minnie Mouse, and we toyed over whether we should cancel the honeymoon and maybe change it to a different date. However, my mum was having none of that. She was adamant that I wasn't changing anything about the wedding or about our honeymoon, and she was just no way. She told me that she'd be fine, she'd be here when I got back, and so I went. The honeymoon was incredible. We had such a good time in America. If you haven't checked out our vlogs, go ahead and check those out. They're all in the playlists, and you'll see that we had a fantastic time. However, what you don't see in those vlogs are the times when I was struggling, the times when I was upset and needing comfort, and the times where I was worrying about my mum and wondering if I'd go home and not have a mum anymore. And that worry really escalated on the day that we checked into the Hard Rock Hotel. It was around 5 days before we were due to come home, and I called my mum every day while we were in America. And on this day, I could just tell she wasn't right. She wasn't speaking properly, she was mumbling, and I got on the phone to my dad, who said that she weren't very well, and they thought that the cancer had spread to her brain and her eyesight had gone funny, and she wasn't very well. This was obviously extremely hard to hear. Thankfully, she was okay after a day or two. It was a water infection. She had a scan on her brain to see what was going on and see if the cancer had moved up there. But the results would take a week or so to come back to confirm whether that was the case or whether it wasn't. I absolutely love going on holiday, and I never want the holiday to end. I know some people go for 2 weeks and say it's a bit long, and by the end of the second week they want to come home. That's absolutely not me. I could just live on holiday forever. Our honeymoon was 3 weeks long, and I know for a fact that had things not been going on at home, I definitely would not have wanted to come home even after 3 weeks. However, that wasn't the case. Things were going on at home, and I desperately wanted to get back home to my mum. So by the end of our honeymoon, I was actually really glad that I was on that plane and I was going home and I was going to see my mum. I'll never forget when I walked into a house and she put her head up to greet me, and she did not... And she didn't look the same anymore. Her eyes had gone really funny due to the cancer moving to her brain, and she was struggling to see. But when I walked in the room, and she saw me, her face just lit up. And I could just see that she was so relieved that I was home, and that she got to see me again. And I got to spend 21 really special days with my mum after getting back from honeymoon, before on the 25th of November she passed away. She didn't want to go into a home, and so me, along with my dad and family, we cared for my mum at home, and she had care nurses coming around every day making sure we were okay and my mum was okay and comfortable. And she passed away surrounded by those who she loved the most, and that was my dad and her children. So, I'm going to explain something else which you, if you've got to the end of this vlog, will have seen, and that was me saying that I am the only one in the world who knows the name of her unborn baby. And the reason behind that is we found out in May about my mum's cancer, and in September my sister found out that she was pregnant. Obviously, we kind of knew that my mum wouldn't be around to see the baby, and that's something that was really hard for her and my sister to deal with. And my sister really wanted to give my mum an important part of the baby's life, even though she maybe wouldn't be here, she wouldn't see the baby, she definitely wouldn't see the baby grow up. She still wanted to give my mum a really important part of the baby's life. And she just come up with the most special idea that I just think is amazing. And that was for my mum to choose the baby's name. And then obviously my mum had to tell me, because otherwise, if when she passed away, nobody would know the name. So my mum chose the baby's name and told me it so that I can do a big reveal to my sister and her partner when the baby's born. And I just think it's such a nice idea. My mum's played a huge, important part of this baby's life. She's chose its name, and I just think it's so special and a really nice thing for my sister to have done. And I'm just so, so excited to reveal the name when the baby's born. And I'm currently looking for good ideas on ways that I can do that. So that's the reason why I'm the only one that knows the baby's name. So after 2015 started out such an amazing, incredible year for me, you know, I had everything ahead of me, I had a wedding to plan, everything was great. And then halfway through the year in May, that all got turned upside down. And it actually turned out to be the hardest year of my life. I had so much going on, I had a wedding to plan, I had time to spend with my mum, and I was trying to come to terms with everything that was going on with her health and the prospect that I was going to lose my mum. And so I had so much going on and so much to deal with. I had an amazing honeymoon to look forward to, and there was just so much going on in my life that I had no time to sit down and really think about what was happening. And then when we got home and my mum sadly passed away, Christmas time came round and I was busy trying to be happy and put on a brave face, because I've still got three little girls who need their mum and don't need somebody who's sat in their bedroom crying all day, which is what I actually wanted to do. I had Christmas, which is my favourite time of year to keep me going. And then come January, which, who loves January? January, February, March are incredibly depressing months of the year, especially for me. I just find the weather, I just don't like January, February and March. And I was faced with everything that was happening and how busy I was last year to suddenly having nothing to plan. And I was scared that I would have a lot of time to sit and think and, I don't know, feel sorry for myself, and just, I didn't want that. I didn't want to sit and go into a really sad, depressed state of mind. So I really needed something to focus on, something positive that I could focus on, and just something that would occupy me and give me something to do. And so that's why we set up our YouTube family channel. We are forever taking pictures and footage of our girls. We've always done it. And we thought, why not upload it to YouTube so that family and friends can take a look and see what we get up to. And that's why we set up our YouTube channel. To be honest, we didn't think anybody else would be interested, and we're really shocked and pleasantly surprised when in only less than three months, we're already at almost 400 subscribers. We're just so grateful, and it's really given me something to focus on, something to do. And when the days where the girls are at school and Chris is at work, I can edit and just see how lucky I am to see what I still have, what an amazing family I have, three beautiful girls that are just so precious, and a husband who adores me. And I just feel incredibly lucky that I still have so much to be thankful for. So I hope that clears everything up, and you all now know why I was at a hospital appointment on Wednesday. It wasn't for me. I'm fine. I'm definitely not pregnant. That's why I know the baby's name. I would end this vlog by saying hope you've enjoyed watching. However, this vlog is probably not one that you will particularly enjoy watching. But I hope it explains a few things and you now know what I got up to on Mother's Day and why this Mother's Day was slightly different and why our YouTube family channel was set up. I hope everyone else had a fantastic Mother's Day, whether you're a mum yourself and you got to spend it with your children or whether you just enjoyed spoiling your mum and spending the day with her. Life is so, so precious. It's a gift, but it's also a gift that can be snatched away without warning. So cherish everyone you love, let them know you love them, don't take anything for granted, and live every day to the absolute fullest. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you real soon.